Hi, welcome to an Arduino tutorial from Robojax. In this video I'm going to show you how you can use two or more LCD1602 display with I2C module on the same Arduino to display data. You can get the code for this by clicking at the link in the description below, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/Arduino. Let's get started with this. In many Arduino applications, you need to connect two or more of these displays to display different values, or maybe extend the wire and place them at different locations to display different parameters. And for that reason, this video will explain that. I have a separate video explaining how the addressing issue of this I2C module is resolved, and also a separate video explaining this fully wiring. So in this video I'm not going to focus on those because I will provide you the link, you can watch them. This is just concerned on how to connect these two, and also I have written a custom function to display the text, decimal, float values and string easily. Let me now explain the wiring. The 5 volts have been connected here. This orange is 5 volts, so we have all this line as 5 volts, and yellow is a ground. Ground is connected in here. For those of you who don't know that, these lines are connected up to here and now provides 5 volts, and all of this line up to here has 5 volts. And then from pin A4 and A5, which the first one is SDA and the other one is SCL, I've connected it to this pin, this blue and green and blue. And from here you can see this 5 volts is connected to the VCC, the second pin, and then the ground, this gray, is connected to the last one, which is ground. And then from here blue is aligned with this blue, which goes to pin A4, and the green is aligned with the green, which goes to A5 on Arduino in the last one. You're using Arduino Uno, and then SCL is A5 and SDA is A4, and Arduino Mega, SDA is 20 and then SCL is 21, and Leonardo and all of those. And here is the addressing. I'm going to solder this part, and there is another one that I've already done it. And it was very hard for me to solder it. What I did was I put this tiny wire and I soldered it. Now I'm gonna clip this. Right now this has been soldered in two. So A0 is now closed. And the address that I've selected if you don't solder anything, for the first one I'm going to leave it as 000, all of them not closed or not soldered, so it will be 27. And then I soldered only this one, the A0. In my case, for the first module, this is the least significant digit in terms of binary reading, and this is the most significant digit. Usually it's supposed to be the other way, A0 should be this way, but I found it like this on the module, so I'm presenting it like this. The first module is not soldered. Not soldered means 00, and when it's soldered it's represented as 1. So A0 is represented for my second module as 1, which has been soldered. And you can continue if you have the third module, you can go for A1, solder it, and then if you have the fourth one, like this. So this table is here, just follow it. These are just binary, this is 0 and this is up to 7. So 0 plus 7, 8. So we have 8 different combination, and it's possible to get more. Now let me explain the code and also demonstrate in here what you will see. The first line starts with wire.h. This is part of Arduino IDE. When you run this program, it's part of it. You don't have to do anything. This liquid crystal underscore I2C.h is a library that I will provide you the link. You have to download and include it in your library. If you don't know how, one way would be click on Sketch, Library, Add Zip Library, and then point towards the zip file. Let's say this is USB zip or whatever. It will be liquidcrystal.zip. Click and open, and it will be included. From this point, we need to define for first display. This is what we do, LCD1 and LCD2. If you have more than two, then just copy this and go next line, make it 3, 4, and I believe up to 8 you can have. And this will take three parameters here, and just take these three arguments. That's the first one is the address, I square C address. The second one is number of characters. The third one, this is number of rows. So we have two rows of 16 characters. For this one, you need to find the address of this module. This I square C module has an address. You need to find that. For that, I will provide you with a scanner. This is the I square C scanner. It has been written online, and let me upload it. And once this runs, it will tell you the address. So I have two item, one is 026 and the other one is 0x32. This 0x mean hex, and 26 is the 26th value of hexadecimal. So it just constantly reads it every few seconds, and you will get the address. And I'm using these two addresses for my two devices. To find out which device is which, you can just disconnect. For example, this is the last one. I'm disconnecting it, and now you will see that we will have only one. So this is 26, 0x26, and this one was 3F. This is the decimal places for float value, for example 0.84. so if you want two decimal places, just put two. If you want three, we make it three. This position is five. Total number for this, so this is 1, 2 with a decimal is 3, 4, 5 total. This you have to change it accordingly, because I have written a code that this can display any value, integer, string. So you can easily send any value and it will be displayed, because there are some issue for that, and this is my solution. Inside the setup, we have to use the begin to initialize the screen. This is LCD1.begin and LCD2.begin for both of those. And also we have to turn on the backlight with LCD1 LCD2. This is this is the serial monitor initialization that here it has this 9600 baud. It must match this number. And after that, this is just a text that shows on this screen. Let me show you. Display 1 in here. And then the same way, we have display 2. After that, this is for the serial monitor. And this is also 3 seconds delay, so the person can read initial information and recognize which display is which. And after that, we will clear the screen with using LCD1.clear and LCD2.clear. So we have to clear both screens so new information can be displayed. And inside the loop, I've defined these values. First, age 31, and then number of days is calculated by age times 365. This is number of days this person is living, and it's being displayed on, as you can see here, the age and this. So I've written here this code LCD display to make it very easy, and it takes all these arguments, 5 arguments here or 4. The one here, it displays 1, so that's referring to the display. And this is referring to the row, and this is referring to the row 1, so that's row 0, this is row 1. And then we say age, and then this age, that text is displayed here because we are at row 0. And then int to a string, I've written this function which I'm going to explain next. It takes this age and converts it to string, and the result will be displayed here as 31. And then this text inside, you see double quotation for the H, you have to put double quotation because it's a text. And that's for the first row. And then for the second row, which is row 0, that's row 1, then we say days, and then this is the value 11,315, and then the text days. Now this is LCD2 display. This is now number 2, same thing. This goes for the display 2, both of them. This is for row 0, row 1, and row 0 we put the text weight, and then this time we use float to string because the weight is float. So we have to convert it to string to display it here, and it shows the weight as 4.84, and then we display the kilogram. And on this second line we display the text, this text voltage, and then we get the voltage 22.1. Here we convert that float into volt value of text, and then we print the V attached to it. Pay attention here, for kilogram I put space, so that's the space, and here I didn't put a space and V is attached. And the reason for converting everything to text is so you can display anything you want, and the value will have either a text. If you have a text, just put the text here inside the quotation, it will be a text. And if you have a float, just use float to string. And if you have integers, just say integer to string, and then inside this you can put a number. Here I put that variable, and this is just a text that displays it in here. For test purpose, if you want to eliminate it, you just eliminate those values that are displayed here. And we have 50 seconds delay, milliseconds delay, and it continues like that. Now let me explain this, and I have to display explain this as well to float. So this value that you pass is here, LCD to LCD display. It gets that value as 1, we call it here display, and then row number, and then the text, and also text. So you see all these three other parameters are text, except these two are integer, and they must be integer. And then it will display the code for us. How it does is that this is for display 1, and we say if this is equal DIS or display equal, we are comparing it. If it's equal 1, we do all this. You don't have to worry about it. This all works simple and explanatory. And for display 2, we just copy and paste this. Here we have display 2, and the only difference is that this says display 1, and here LCD2. And if you have the third one, just copy this, paste it below, and make this 3, and then everything else 2, the 2 change into 3. And if you have 4, 5, up to 8, you can do the same thing. And here we have clear row. I have written a function below clear row. Every time you display a text here, you must clear the previous value. And this, the job of this one is to clear the row. And here, the same thing. If D is equal, this D is display, which display you want to clear and which row. And here we say, if display is equal 1, clear display 1, LCD1. Set cursor and then print blank. And for display 2 also we say LCD2, and then copy this and paste it inside in here for the 3 and 4, 5 and up to 8. Here integer to string, this just converts, takes this A as an integer and converts it to a string, and this gets float to a string, this code, which facilitate all of this for you. So you can just use this one and easily display the text. Thank you for watching. This was how to use two or more LCD of 1602 using Arduino. If you like this video and learn something from it, please thumb up. Please put your comment or question in the comment section below. I will try to answer and reply. And please subscribe so you can get updates of my upcoming videos.